Hi guys, Michael Fights with Friends. Since I was 12 years old, I have heard stories about the count on the Buster Douglas versus Mike Tyson fight. There was so much controversy on that. Don King even said he was going to get it overturned because he felt that the count wasn't correct. Not the most trustable guy. But now I've taken the two counts together, side by side, Buster Douglas's and Mike Tyson's. They both appeared to be the same count. Buster Douglas was allowed to go on and recover, with it being the end of the round. Mike Tyson, of course, was not, lost his belt that night in Tokyo. Does this solve the mystery? One piece of the puzzle is that Mike Tyson did reach out for the referee as he came in. He was trying to put his mouthpiece back in as well, so the referee could have determined that he was more out of it. But the controversy about it was always about the count. I think that this video solves that. 28 years later, I finally took the time to do the analysis on this. And I think we have an answer, at least as far as the count. I was inspired this week, of course, by the Tyson Fury Deontay Wilder fight. We were talking about that in stream. So I decided, well, I'm going to go back and finally do the work on this. I've been complaining about it, you know, or thinking about it for so many years. Why not go back and get this solved? So I think this does solve some answers. I want to know what you guys think. Does this solve the mystery? Should a Mike Tyson been able to go on? Should a Buster Douglas been counted out? Like I said, it seems to be the exact same count. If you're new here, please hit that subscribe button. Everybody, please hit that like button. Make sure your notifications are on. You hit that bell so you get a notification every time I go live or post a video. As always, I love you. I respect you. And I'll see your fine asses later.